Was it Lucifer, old dragon, old serpent, Satan, Lucifer, devil, demons? Hello?
Amen.
It is still the same enemy. Praise God.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Many have lost many battles to this enemy because we don't understand him. Praise God.
Amen.
Now let me give you a brief story of who devil is. Praise God. Somebody open to the book of Revelation chapter 12. And I need somebody to open to Isaiah chapter 14. Revelation, let's read the Revelation first. Praise God.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 12, I read from verse 7. Are you there? Say amen.
Amen.
Okay. And there was war in heaven. Listen. Hello.
Amen.
You see, this individual, whenever he appears, war takes place. So for you to sit at ease as if nothing is happening, it is to your own detriment. For you to think over your marriage that nothing is going on, then you woke up this morning and smile to your wife, or your wife smile to the husband, somebody is just not happy with it. Then you can tomorrow eat whatever that pleases you. You just feel like eating puree tomorrow morning. And you can afford it. Somebody is not happy about it. Then you are even sitting here today wearing cloth to cover your nakedness. Somebody is not happy about it. Hello?
Hi.
Satan never leaves his captives. When he captures you until you are buried, he don't give you. Now, I read from verse 7. And there was one in heaven, Michael and his angel fought against the dragon. And the dragon and his angels fought and prevailed not. Neither was their place found anymore in heaven. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent, called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth. And his angels were cast out with him. And I heard a voice, a loud voice, saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength, and the kingdom of our God, and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of their testimony, and the love of their lives unto the dead. Therefore, rejoice ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knoweth that he had but a short time. Listen, Satan on earth, we must realize, is an enemy that lost the battle. His identity has already been marked. He's a loser. Hello? The history of how we came, last time I told us, this event is recorded in Revelation. But this event occurred before Genesis. Chapter 1. The other side, let me not go into it. The other story about it, let me not go there. But one key I want you to understand, that it was an event that took place before Genesis chapter 1 was written. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
There is only one phrase in Genesis chapter 1 that happened before this. And it was the phrase that says, in the beginning, God created heavens and the earth. That was the only thing that came before this event. Because those who went to the school, there is a great gap between that Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. It is not just a serial thing. There was a very big gap in between Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 and Genesis chapter 1
verse 2.
Now, the Bible said that There was war in heaven that brought about the fall of Satan. Now I want you to get one thing clear in your head. That Satan can be defeated. Hello? Look at someone and say, he can be defeated. Look at two people and tell them, he can be defeated. Listen, God has never been defeated. That's why we have confidence that he will never be defeated. Satan has once been defeated. That's why we know that he can still be defeated again. Look at two people and tell them, he can be defeated.
Somebody said they never lost.